So it's the first challenge to me is how to be innovative to cut short the time now. So it's, maybe I cut short the slides. I think the easiest thing to do. But I'll try to quickly go through, because you've been hearing excellent talks. Last two talks been going on details and the stories of the importance of innovation. So even though I have stories like that, but I don't want to go into the details. Like, they've done an excellent job on that. But I go more into a little more abstract and overall sense of the culture, how to bring the culture, and what is needed to bring this culture. I think that's what I'm going to go. So in any culture, in terms of innovation, it's the trio here, which is government, industry, and university. They have to be together here. So if that is not maintained, the culture cannot be maintained, because it's all of them have to support each other, because nothing can go steadily. So they're always a phase goes up and down, and it's very important they three go together, because the regulations comes from the government, the need comes from the industry, the potential comes from the university. So the innovation happens everywhere, and there has to be the proper communications between them. So it's basically the balance of the collaboration between these three to have a healthy innovation culture, which is very important in my view. Some of the stories why important, why the industry has to have more culture here. I'll come to that from industry point of view, because it's not only the university is going to be innovative, its industry has to be equally innovative. Why? There are many stories like surface enhanced Raman spectroscopy, which is a very old technique where Sir C.V. Raman had it in 1930s. But the device never came, never proven into practice till 70s and 80s, because even though theoretically the technology is known, the technique is known, can never be applied, because it's never been R&D, has not been done, innovation not been done in the industry to develop them into product, okay? So the first, there was a France company who's put those ideas into practice, okay? So the France company, a lot of innovations undone, and they made the first product on SERS, even though they kept the Raman there, but it's the France company which took care of it, not an Indian, even the idea came from Indian. The other thing is, in Optania Incorporated, where I worked, it's a good example, as it's a small startup company, but innovation is the bread of the company. So we used to make almost every week, every 2 weeks, a pattern used to come out of that, okay? So it's not all the patterns are useful, at least 20 to 30% of the patterns eventually will be useful. So that was the bread and butter of the company. So it's very important for the company to sustain that we need to keep innovating it, okay? Laurier, which is, you all know that, it's a cosmetic company. They're the highest number. It's a nice coincidence that I have a pat. We worked also on the glaucoma cancer detections, not from this imaging sensing, not from mechanical biosensing. So we have a pattern on that, how to detect this glaucoma even before they set into this eye. Because the detection that he was mentioning is about, well, once it's settled into eyes, okay, that comes to the later stage. But it's also possible to even detect this glaucoma even before it sets in, when the cancer cells are being circulated in the bloodstream. Okay, there was, so we came up with some biosensing device for that. So what I'm saying is, the innovations can be at any level. It doesn't matter at what level it is. Innovation could be big or small, could be at the initial stage or final stage. But innovation can be at any level. It's a matter of seeing the significance and the relevance. That's what I think I said is, we have to keep our eyes open to see whether ideas are any relevant to the industry, any relevance to the applications, okay? So the moment we see the relevance to however the idea is small or big, the moment we see the relevance, like that's where the innovation is, okay? So culture means here is, the culture means creating the culture of thinking to looking for relevance into every activity that we do. I think that's something fundamental here. Because if we don't, otherwise we can skip all the great ideas that we do, okay? We'll be doing innovative ideas, but if we don't know the potential, the relevance of it to the industry or to the people, then essentially we miss the point, okay? So what is any engineer working in industry or any student, whoever it is, however small, however big it is, we have to tune your mind to how to see the relevance of our work. However excellent work we do, and it has to be significant and relevant to that applications. I think that's the whole idea. The culture is nothing but breeding the relevance into the mind of what we do. That's the whole thing. Another thing, the golf, I think I take the very nice example. It's Dr. Iyengar put a very interesting of innovation of golf to predict the motions, and so we can train you can make a good golfie sort of any ordinary persons. The next level of innovation is, you can also put an actuator with him. Okay, so the actuators, you see the corrections in the movement, maybe actuators can guide him also to push it. So instead of the person itself correcting himself, we can also put some actuators along so you can have external help to it. The next level of innovations. So innovations can be at any level, it doesn't matter. It could be sensing level, actuations level, or system level, a component level, whatever the level it is. That is very important, as I said, to see the relevance. That's something, but the relevance is a culture. It doesn't come in one day. I think this is something I want to strongly say, that it doesn't come in one day. It comes the training of a people. The training of a people starts from the high school to the college to the industry. I think this is a long process, okay? It's even the high school, you could teach what's the relevance. You could teach the high school kids how to be smart and how to be innovative. I think if you start from there, I think you've done our job, actually. Then he will be innovative when he comes to the industry. I think there's no point. I think that would be the best way to start, my opinion is that, okay? From the industry point of view, the bottom line is the reputation, whether the competitiveness, or the cutting-edge technology, the advantage, whatever they have, the access to the market, the stability of the market, how long they're going to stay in the market. Basically, you can measure those innovations into number of patents a company has. Okay, so the company has to have that focus on producing number of patents. Otherwise, I think they lose a business over a time. So I will say the innovation will be the foundation of a building. It's like a foundation of a building. If any company that doesn't have the innovations, doesn't have a creation, so it's basically service companies and stuff, they can't be in the business for a long time, because you have to keep changing your product. You have to keep changing your focus of the product line and all that. It's a must. We've been seeing yesterday, the whole yesterday, we were listening so many talks on that, right? Innovation is the key and the foundations, okay? Otherwise, the industry becomes very volatile. To the volatility of the industry increases, okay? You can, anytime you can be out of the business. So it's very important to be sustained. You can only sustain by having more number of patents and breeding the culture in the company so that you keep producing more patents and keep breeding into the people about the relevance of the work they do. I think that's a whole thing, okay? And without which the company cannot plan a long-term success, a long-term thing. So I would see the industry and the university collaboration goes like a push-pull mechanisms, okay? Yeah, university can create a technology, but that has to be pulled by the industry. If industry doesn't have the way to pull it, what are the technology university creates? It goes to the papers and conferences, and finally to the archives and the library. That's done. As we used to, it doesn't reach the people. Okay, so it's important we have to establish this, the push and pull mechanism between the industry and the university. Okay, or research labs and industry. Okay, there has to be there so that especially my field is micro nanotechnologies. This is exactly the application specific technologies. Okay, I could create all kind of lab. I can create all kind of technologies, ideas in the lab, but if you don't see them into the market, I think the whole thing will be dead. It's a dead end. Okay, and what's the point in it? Okay, so some of the technologies are basically application driven. And they have to follow this model of push-pull mechanisms, which will be only done by the very strong industries which have a strong culture in terms of innovations. Okay. So my thing is, innovation is not a sudden phenomenon. It doesn't come in overnight. We have been seeing this because when all the multinational companies, we have been seeing, they keep the innovations there. They only come here for services, and they can all this be here. But still now a lot of innovations happening here, which was hearing, but it doesn't happen over time. So it is a long-term process, okay? It's a long-term process, so which has to be achieved through this model of excellence, significance, and relevance, okay? So we are doing excellent work, no doubt about it. And it has to signify something, no doubt about it. And it has to be relevant to the people and the need. It's no doubt about it. So we have to have these three things. Even a lot of R&D labs in Canada, for example, National Research Council, which is used to be the excellent lab earlier, they have the slogan now, relevance has been added to all the scientists. So they cannot do simply as blue sky research anymore. It has to be relevant to the industries. Okay, this is one of the pressure from all the granting agencies in North America, which is, it's a must for us. Okay, so it has to be here too. That's the only way to be success. So it's a time-involved process. That means it needs to be evolved, which needs a lot of training, okay? So it's a lot of training, it's a time-involved process, so we have to create a culture and the mindset among the people. So how to do that? It's a creation of culture. We need to have skilled people. Definitely, we have to train them. We have to have a system in place. We have been hearing system in place. So we have to have the system in place. Good people, good training people, good managers, and there is a support system in the industry or university to promote this, basically the innovations, okay? Whether you're applying a patent or a legal lawyer you hire, right? All kind of system that has to be in place. So you are not, otherwise it's a long process. Student cannot do it. Simple engineers cannot do it. We need a big support to do that, okay? And very fundamental thing, as I told you, is the students finally go to the industries. So the students have to have this mindset from the high school, from the university into the industry. That means we have to, I think, time to introduce some courses in the curriculum of the university itself, especially in master and PhD students, how important to protect ideas, how important to be innovative, okay? Apart from being researched and doing, or how to be innovative. As we have been hearing, how small ideas can make big changes in life, okay? So how to see that small ideas can, how to see the relevance, okay? And I think it'll come when you have a proper training and courses, this kind of, people have to go to the industry, sorry, universities, and talk to the students. It's happening in most of the universities now, okay? A lot of industrial people are coming to universities, have one-to-one contact with the students, and try to tell them the value of innovations, okay? This is happening now, okay? And like all the capstone projects that the students do in universities could be a very good starting point for this innovation process, okay? So I think it has to start from through course curriculum and training of the students itself. My example I can share with you, I at least have one pattern with most of my students. So every student that go out of my lab, at the end they have one pattern with them. At least they see the relevance, okay? I try to teach them the value of innovations into the mind, okay? So they go to the industry, they start looking for those innovations that comes out of that. Even there are, at least from Canada, I can see my province, the government has a support. If some students have an idea from the university, he want to develop a company, start up a company, the government is ready to invest money on the student. Okay? The government is ready to money invest on the student so that he can develop a company, try his idea, so that he can venture out and take some risk. Okay? So if he fails, the government writes it off. If he goods, then he has to pay back. All this is there are so that the government can come in that way to create this culture, because eventually the culture will be in the industries. Okay? And so it's very important here, and also the industry has to update the knowledge so that the culture is maintained. So it's very important, how small, how big, it is important to look for the relevance which comes with only with the time and the training, to me, which can start even at high school level. I think with that I finish, and thank you.